these days, you know, internet is this human right that everyone needs in order to live their lives, except that it isn't.
1.5 million New Yorkers lack home broadband access, and it's all bluntly about the profit motive.
They carve out different areas so they don't have to compete.
You want to be on the internet? You don't have another option.
They have a monopoly, basically.
But a group of volunteers in New York City is fighting back. They're banding together to provide internet at little to no cost. And it could be a model for bringing more people online and finally bridging the digital divide.
The idea is to basically take back ownership of their own network instead of relying on the big cable monopolies to do it for them. At one point, you just have to stand up and say, there's got to be a better way.
This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems.
Are you using the NYC Mesh now?
Yeah, we're going over it now.
I'm Brian Hall. I helped start NYC Mesh about 7 years ago.
NYC Mesh is a community-led nonprofit expanding internet service to areas where there are few provider options or where the existing provider options are unaffordable.
1.5 million people in the city, mainly low-income people of color, lack both home and wireless broadband service.
In New York, there are a few large service providers, and agreements between those providers and the city that promised to expand coverage for years never happened. So the net result is that neighborhoods with the most service options tend to be wealthier.
For profits, business, it just goes where the money is.
Providers invest in infrastructure where they know they can make more money. But that leaves everyone else with little choice. Where there's no competition, there's little market force to drive down prices. So even if a provider offers service, many can't afford it.
I hear people getting billed over $100, they'd see their price goes up just because they realize, you know, the cable companies know there's no other options in your area. What are you going to do?
And that's what led Daniel to NYC Mesh. After frustrations with his existing provider, he found the service and is now both a customer and a volunteer who helps install antennas and routers for new members like Danielle, who've made the jump to the service after similarly bad experiences.
It was terrible. It rhymed with Mectrum, and it started with an S. Super unreliable, which became even more noticeable once the pandemic started because I would be in the middle of an online exam and my internet would go out.
What they give you for the price is so bad and so unusable that, you know, at one point you just have to stand up and say, there's got to be a better way. So this is sort of where NYC Mesh is born out of.
Let's do this.
NYC Mesh is different than traditional providers in both its tech and its approach. On the tech side, NYC Mesh has so-called supernodes, which are powered by fiber connections and mounted high up in the city. Those supernodes distribute signals to smaller hubs and routers around the city, thus creating the mesh network.
So for install today on Wilson Avenue, we have a couple options. From the panorama, we were able to discern that we have line of sight to two of our hubs. We might get better signal from Saratoga, but we might get better speed from Vernon, depending. At each building or node, you have a smaller antenna that kind of looks like a dish, and a repeater antenna that basically both connects over to the hub and then also is able to locally spread the Wi-Fi in that block, which makes it a lot easier and a lot cheaper for people on that same block to connect in the future.
And service fees are donation-based. NYC Mesh suggests a $20 to $60 monthly donation based on what you can afford. But those who need it get service free of charge.
We keep our costs really low, and if your card gets canceled, we'll never cut you off. Now, if you can't afford internet, you still should get internet.
All right, we are elevated. All right, let's all go home. I'm kidding.
The whole operation is run by volunteers. Customers pay up front for the hardware, with subsidies available for those who need it. But all installations are done by volunteers. Volunteers also troubleshoot and fix connectivity problems as they arise.
At the beginning, I was, you know, your typical
tech guys. now it's just everybody.
The antenna we just installed today, those are Danielle's now. She owns them. And other people who then buy their antennas can connect to her antenna and become part of the mesh. So it's really just all of these like individual community members. It's not like one person or one company that decide what the rules are, essentially. It's just we all do that together.
All right, let's see if I get internet.
Sweet. Okay, 80 megabits, and we're, okay.
that feeling of when it worked and I was able to get like a good speed and it was working, and I was just like, this is unreal. Why don't more people know about this?
Thank you, Mesh.
Yeah, of course.
One thing I hear a lot is like, how does this scale? When you build a network that is intrinsically dependent on your infrastructure being located in strategic positions and be able to access as many people as possible, you really need a community behind that. I'm able to reach out to some of my neighbors to see if they're having issues. We can collaborate on things, we can help other people who are around, connected to the same hub, and we can all work together on these solutions, and that's what makes the mesh happen.
To make up for earlier missteps, New York has also rolled out an internet master plan designed to get more people online. That plan includes ways for community efforts like NYC Mesh to grow, such as increasing permissions for them to install nodes on more rooftops and on streetlights, which expands the mesh network.
That's sort of the idea why we want to build more hubs in more neighborhoods so we can ensure those really fast speeds for everyone.
NYC Mesh isn't the first service of its kind. In fact, the largest community-run internet network is in Spain and consists of nearly 40,000 nodes. But these efforts could provide a roadmap for communities all around the world to take control over their ability to get online.
No one in this country thought we could do infrastructure with a community group, and we're doing it. And you can do amazing things just by organizing.
The more that the community can sort of like lift us up, the more we can essentially compete with these big names and provide a better, cheaper, I think friendlier alternative.